It is a gorgeous, beautiful, sunny day at Possum Run Homestead. We are getting ready, and I mean we this time. I have company coming over today, and they're going to help me do a project, a big project. This is something y'all been waiting for and asking me about for a while now. Where you going to live? What you going to do? When you sell the bus, you're going to have no place to live. Are you going to live in the bus? No, because it's going to be sold. Are you going to live in the truck? No, because, yeah, it's a little small. Are you going to live in the shed? Maybe. No, I'm not going to live in the shed. That was an alternative. It definitely was. So was the truck. But I've got a different alternative now. Because I was gifted a wonderful surprise by a neighbor, not a YouTuber. He's a friend and neighbor who is a very, very kind and helpful person. And he got a hold of me one day last week and he says, "Hey, I'm trying to get rid of some stuff that's just sitting around the place and I am over it." He said, "I'm not going to go through selling this stuff." He says, "If you want anything here," he says, "you come over here and look and see what I got." He says, "But I also have this camper." He says, "And it's not that great. Falling apart." He says, "But it's dry. It doesn't leak." And he says, "If you want it, you can have it. Fix it up if you want to." He says, "I'll give you the title." He says, "You can sell it after you're done with it, and it'll make somebody else a nice place. Guest house, or I could use it for a guest house. If somebody doesn't have a home, it'd give them a place to live." I says, "You know, whatever you do to it, do to it." He says, "And when you're done with it, get rid of it." So that's what I'm going to do. So my friends, Jamye and Kevin from O'Rourke's Littlefield, they are YouTubers, go check out their channel, are coming over here today, and we are going to do a deep clean on this camper, and then we're going to get it moved up here, or we're going to move it up here and then do a deep clean on the camper. More than likely, that's what will happen. But it's a beautiful, gorgeous, sunny, a little bit breezy day. So it's going to be an awesome day for working outside. I'm ready to get out of the bus and get back to work outside. And this is the next step to getting that done. So let's go check it out. We'll see what it looks like before. We'll see what it looks like afterwards. Let's do this, y'all. Time to get to work. All right, y'all, look who I got here. Jamye, Kevin's back there.
Working, we got him working.
He's working. We are getting the new home, temporary home, situated. So let me show you. I have not.
See, I said I had a secret.
See, let's go see it real quick. Ta-da! MamaV's new temporary home. Looks a heck of a lot better than did a couple of days ago when I got it. It had some major little issues that I have now fixed. Whoa, I'm still standing here. We gotta watch that other side. I'm gonna watch that tree back there.
Okay, what is this?
This big oak tree back here might be an issue. That's the culvert. All right, you're good right now.
Where do you need me?
I don't know. Watch that post on the right side. We can pull that post if we need to.
You're good.
Your cedar post. I don't know about the other side. Ooh, we're going to make it. We're going to make it. We're going to make it. We're going to make it.
Perfect. That's probably good. I mean,
yeah,
it's a little further out, but it's so much longer than my other one. I mean, just making sure we're level.
Where do you plug it in?
The plug is on the other side on the back, and there's nothing I can do about it.
It's
got a plug in right there. Now I'm gonna have to get an extension. It's like $70. The plug on this is back there on that back corner there. So I think it's far enough back.
You gonna be able to hook up any lights or anything?
I don't know. I mean, at the worst, I can throw an extension cord in there.
Right, that's what I'm saying. You got something to plug in and have light.
Just a regular extension cord, or I can go get me one of them, I guess. I don't know. If you think we can find a way to get this cord out of here, you know how to break a lock? I think you are. I think you're good.
I saw there was some jacks.
There he is.
Inside in the box.
There he is.
It did it.
Wrong way.
Yeah.
Let's pull away.
Do we need to put the blocks under the wheels?
Chalk it?
Yeah. Well, we already unhooked it, so.
Y'all are $1 short.
Yeah, we already unhooked it, so yeah, we'll chalk it and then. Tire even on the ground. Well, there she is. All set up in her new home. This is a newer brand, 1980s, early 80s camper. And it will be perfectly fine for what we need to do. Temporary home. It's our temporary home. Okay, there, we got the fire out. Woo! Ew! Nah, I don't think so.
It's a dirt dollar or something.
This is roof coating, he said.
Joyful right. Cleaning has arrived.
Good, I'm stepping along.
Uh-oh. We in trouble now. already cleaning. We just got it set. Okay, y'all, we're done for today. I know, in there, it doesn't look a whole lot different than it did this morning, except for it's clean. It's clean. Now, we've moved a bunch of my stuff in there now. But I could not have done this without these two, Jamye and Kevin from O'Rourke's Little Field. They come over here and they helped me get the camper up here.
We helped Kevin get it up the hill.
That's right. We guided him. And then Jamye did most of the deep cleaning.
My sick
obsession. That's what she does.
My sick obsession about dirt. There was probably 1,000 wasps in there, dead wasps in there.
Yep.
Yeah.
I think it was used as a hunting camper.
Great shape.
Amazing shape.
What were you saying? You were like 13 when it was built?
I was 12.
12. I mean, it's...
Yeah.
It's in great shape.
It is.
I mean, the outside needs a scrubbing and stuff, but...
Yeah. Yeah. Hey. She needs cleaned up on the outside, but I'm not wasting rainwater on that, so...
No.
It will be all right.
It's huge.
But it's big. It's got lots of room. It's got a full bathroom, 2 twin beds, a pull-out, full-size pull-out bed in the front, and the couch, big couch. It's got a Dometic refrigerator freezer that works.
Yes.
Has a stove and oven that works.
Everything.
Yep, everything works.
Everything works.
My neighbor came over and did some plumbing work for me because there was a plumbing leak. And I probably could have figured it out, but he wasn't. He was here and had it fixed in just a couple minutes. Yeah.
I mean, minor.
Right. And it helped us figure out a couple other little things, too, that... We're just simple stuff.
And as big as it is, what'd you say it is? It's like how many?
It's 25 feet.
25
it's 28
feet.
With the hitch.
And we've got the little balancers under there. There's That's no
right.
bounce.
That's right. It doesn't move.
That's how well built this thing is. It's solid.
That's right.
I mean, it is solid.
We still got this little mess right here to clean up, or I do, before I turn in for the night. But it's trash stuff that come out of there that I don't want to keep or don't need extra pieces of carpet. And an old table that was up against the wall. And
the hummingbirds have been checking out the fake flowers.
Oh, and some fake flowers. but yeah, we've got a few things left to do here, but we're wrapping it up. And they are going to head down on the road.
We're actually going to go look at a piece of property that's over at Dardanelle.
There you go. They're going shopping.
Sears and Roebuck house.
All right.
Yeah. So, on like, what, 13 acres? Yeah.
Yeah.
Like
Very
that.
Cool. And okay. I'm going to continue moving stuff over from the bus to the camper and then settling in for the night on my nice twin size bed.
I'm so happy for Willie.
Yep. Willie gets to have a new home.
A big home to him.
With carpet.
Yeah.
Instead of just vinyl flooring.
You be good boy. All right. We got to go. Nice to see everybody.
All right. We'll see you next time. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Have a Love safe you. Trip home. Love you too. All right. Let's take a little look. See here. We got 2 propane tanks that are full of propane. Little awning in the front. We have a nice screen door. Of course, the door that I rebuilt. I put down a potty pad because he's not used to having carpet on the floor. So, I did put a potty pad down. We have a couch. My kitchen stuff, I'll show you again later once I get everything cleaned up. And I put my refrigerator in here. Although it does have a fridge in here, that one is for the house. That one's going in the cabin. We have a stove and oven. My Ninja Foodie, of course. A double sink. All the water works, running water. We filled it up from my rain catchment. We have a Dometic, Royal Dometic refrigerator, freezer that runs off propane or electric, and solid, so it's working. Frozen refrigerator. The light doesn't work, but it is cold in here, so the refrigerator works. All right, we have a big storage cabinet right here. Storage up on that top. Over here, all of our, there's the power. Water pump works. Hold intake one, empty. Hold intake two, empty. Water level, empty, because the water's, it's not full yet. I don't have very much water in there right now. And the condition of the battery is excellent. Right there, it shows you. We also have the thermometer. It says that it is 60, just over 70 degrees. That's a SureFlow water pump. The vent line range hood and the Wedgewood stove. An oven, excellent condition and clean. Got the microwave up here. It's got a plug inside of there. We've got the drawers. I already started putting some of my stuff in there. Cabinets here, and back here we have two twin beds, which I'm in the process of making. Two closets, full closets. There we go. This one has the breaker in it. The one is exactly the same. It's got shoe storage at the bottom, a drawer, and a hanging closet. We have a full bathroom with double closets on this side with hangers. We've got a medicine cabinet. We've got a drawer and a storage at the bottom there. We've got storage here. Storage there for the toilet paper and all that stuff. A bathtub with a shower curtain. And a shower.
All right, y'all. Hope you liked that one. This camper is amazing, and it is my new home for a little while I build the cabin and get some other things done around here. I can't thank Jamye and Kevin enough for coming up here and helping me out, getting this camper into place, and Jamye for being the cleaning boss, because she just told me to get out of her way. She wanted to do it. She deep cleaned the camper, and it is awesome. So that's it for this one. We'll catch you on the next one. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to the channel if you like my content. Have a great week. God bless.